She was my best friend, and it's still hard for me to talk about her. She was, you know, every woman in a way. She was a wife, a mother, she was a volunteer. She loved volunteering. She loved doing things for people. She died when she was 36, so it was much too short a time. And she had a short, painful journey with breast cancer. She was diagnosed when she was 33. Even when she was so ill at the end, she was still doing things for people. And she was maybe just a few weeks from dying. That's the kind of person she was. This organization lives like my sister, it feels like her, and it looks like her. We've got the world in our hands. Now we're gonna start a new day. The Race for the Cure was really developed as a way to create a breast cancer community for people. It was right as, I didn't know it at the time, I was developing breast cancer.
Well, for me, what's so special, amazing, breathtaking, literally breathtaking about Nancy is that she could have given in to the grief of losing a sister and a best friend.
It looks amazing here. I'm so happy to see each and every one of you. I'm Rabbi Vicki Tuckman.
She instead went public and external and energetic and took it to a completely new place where the ability, the freedom, to be able to talk about breast cancer and not to feel shy or reserved about it is because she really put it on the map.
My mom was diagnosed in 1974 with breast cancer, and at the time they didn't talk about breast cancer. They didn't even say cancer out loud, they went. And I think that the Komen Foundation has given it a name and given it a face. They know what it is now, and they talk about it, and they know to look for it, and I think we have a lot more survivors now because of it.
I was so extraordinarily lucky to have a sister like that. How I wish I would have had her for so many more years, but I do through this organization now.
From NBC News, this is Today.
She is a mother, an advocate, a survivor, and an ambassador. Nancy Goodman Brinker is a woman making a difference.
I'm Nancy Goodman Brinker. Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
As the White House Chief of Protocol, Brinker advises the President on official diplomatic matters.
She's just been named one of Time Magazine's most influential people in the world.
Gives me goosebumps because one woman, Nancy, created the Susan G. Komen Foundation in 1982 to fulfill that promise to her baby sister. Now, her organization has given over $1 billion for breast cancer research.
My mother and dad felt that we needed to give back to the community all the time, that we needed to lead by example. We needed to be the best representatives we could of what it meant to be a Reformed Jew, what it meant to be a Jew.